Good morning, everybody. My name is Genevieve Sharona, and I live in the city of Sacramento. And with me are Deborah Ortiz and Ann Rudin, and women who are concerned about the police investigation into the allegations last year about the inappropriate touching of a student by Kevin Johnson, and also the allegations regarding an AmeriCorps volunteer. And we have been reading with growing alarm in the newspaper about the investigation. We feel that it was mishandled. There is a cloud over this investigation, and even the Sacramento Bee this past weekend indicated that both the way it was handled at Sac High and also the way that the police have investigated this is very questionable. There is a cloud. We care very much about this city. The police chief can clear this up quickly by releasing the files and showing, was the investigation done properly? We feel this is very, very important for we women of the city of Sacramento to step forward and make this statement and take this stand, because our teenage girls need to have confidence in the police department that, in fact, their rights are going to be protected, and if something inappropriate has happened, that they can be safe in stepping forward. In releasing these files, of course, the privacy of the individuals involved must be protected. There is a way for the police to do that. We saw that with the report that was given by the Phoenix Police Department. The Phoenix Police Department blocked out the names in the report. The full report was given. Chief Brazil needs to do the same thing in the case that's happened here in Sacramento, and that will bring confidence. It will lift the cloud from this investigation, and it will bring confidence back to not only the families of Sacramento, we women of Sacramento, but also the teenagers. We also feel that it's very important that the police chief assure us that the police are properly trained in how to deal with sex abuse allegations and how to investigate. Then we have questions about who was interviewed, the timing, and there is a terrible cloud over this investigation, and we think the police chief can clear this up very quickly by releasing the files. At this point, I would like to turn it to Deborah Ortiz to provide some comments.
Thank you so much, Genevieve and others. There has been certainly a lot of attention paid recently to allegations of that are troubling to me as a Sacramento resident and as a woman. And I watched the accounts of not only the situation here in Sacramento, but certainly the situation in Phoenix, that really created the greatest alarm when I read, as many others did in the Sacramento Bee, that not only did it appear that that the investigation, if one could call it that, that was conducted by Mr. Johnson's personal attorney, his business partner, not only did not comply with the law is very clear, the penal code provision says that the report shall be completed and made, a complaint shall be filed within 36 hours. In this case, Mr. Johnson's attorney and business partner filed that complaint, or made the contacted or reported the incident a week after the incident occurred. And he reported that incident after he himself, an interested party in my assessment, personally spoke to the young woman, and then it was subsequently determined to be unfounded. The law doesn't say that the police department has a discretion to after a incident is found to be unfounded, that then forgives or washes away the failure to require the mandated reporter to report in 36 hours. So a legitimate question that I have for our police department is the fact that the interested party filed a report a week after the incident occurred in clear violation of the penal code, was that an issue for our police department? Secondly, was our police department at all concerned that perhaps there may have been a conflict of interest by Mr. Johnson's representative, business partner, and personal attorney, by all accounts, who handled what appears to be a secret settlement in the Phoenix situation as well? Whether the nature of that investigation and ultimately delayed report by Mr. Johnson's attorney whether or not that raised a concern with our police department. And I was also troubled, quite frankly, when comments were made by Mr. Tinsdale, who himself said that he personally investigates these cases of sexual abuse, that he had determined that Mr. Johnson was not a predator, and this was based on the Phoenix incident. It just alarmed me as a woman, and it caused me to ask whether or not our police department has adequate training internally in these cases, when those kind of comments by a representative of the police department, in whatever context, a union endorsement context, whether or not that suggests something more troubling in our department. Let me say that I want to give our police department the benefit of the doubt, and certainly Chief Brazil, who has had a stellar career. But the very simple question, why they didn't then say a 36-hour penal code requirement for mandated reporting was completed in a week, that in and of itself ought to have raised a question. Let me also say that the call for a fuller explanation to the public can include releasing a report with redacted information to protect the identity of the minor. I think that is essential, and that's a given. And it can be done, and it can be completed. But answering those simple questions, why did they allow a violation of the penal code that requires 36 hours of the mandated reporter's action? And secondly, were they at all alarmed that perhaps the individual that ultimately, after 1 week, made the report may have had a personal conflict of interest, a professional conflict of interest? Those are two questions that I would welcome our police department responding to. And in the end, let me just say, this is really about the future of this community. It's about the integrity of our police department that is charged with protecting young women. And it's, quite frankly, troubling in a climate that appears to be less than cognizant of the rationale behind the law. The law is designed to protect the alleged victim. And the 36-hour provision is because the likelihood of intimidation or duress on an alleged victim is so critical, and also preservation of evidence. So the fact that 36-hour requirement for this penal code was not adhered to in and of itself is troubling. And I certainly would welcome an explanation from the police department that there are apparently two separate reports that may indeed be related to the same incident. A simple response, whether or not they release the contents of the report, to simply say to the public, no, there's only one report, or indeed there are two reports, and this is the reason for two separate reports. And let me just, I look forward to questions, but let me also say that this is a question of the integrity of our police department that's charged with protecting young women. And it's time to revisit whether or not this community feels strongly about the nature of the allegations, not in one instance. We're talking about three separate incidents, probably four. And in that context, I felt compelled to make a public statement. And I hope that our community and our police department feels equally strongly about the frequency and the nature of the way this was handled. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Deborah. And
Jerome. Sure. Yes, thank you. I'm concerned that if this matter is not set, made public and laid to rest now, it's going to continue to be a question of the integrity, not only of the police department, of the schools that allowed information to be concealed. It's also going to deter any student, any young woman or young man from reporting sexual abuse, because that person will know that there is likely to be information that can be withheld. This is going to set a precedent for that. We cannot withhold information on an incident that happened that is clearly against the law. We want to find out if that incident happened, if that student had that experience. It's always going to be a matter of will I be believed? Does it matter if I report it? Will anybody care? Will anybody do anything about it? We have to be concerned about that. I would like to see the police department reveal all of the information that they have. It's a matter of public disclosure, and I think it's a necessity if they want to maintain their integrity, and I've always been very proud of our police department, if they want to maintain their integrity, they have to be very open with all of the information that they have. And I hope that they will take our comments seriously and release whatever they know, whatever reports have not been released in the past, so that the public knows exactly what happened or didn't happen.
Thank you, Anne.